eagle. Another day in Corner Town. And breakfast with Bob.
Pacho Man. Thank you, sir. My name is Bob Babbitt. We are Beautiful Huggers on the Rocks. We are brought to you by ES Myoplex, by Polar, by VeloFix, Normatec, Four Seasons Hualalai. We'll be having our championship edition on Sunday. Our next guest wants to be there with us. And also Amy Opayo, power breather. Mr. Bart Arnotz joins us from Belgium. How you doing, Bart?
Yeah, I'm good. I feel still quite relaxed. It's two days out of the race. So, I had a good couple of days in Kona.
Yes.
I feel quite adapted to the heat and the conditions. And it's not my first time, so it helps.
Well, and you finished 8th, 9th, and 8th. And last year you were 8th here. Ran 2:48. You always seem to run well here. Coming from Belgium, you're not used to this type of heat, but your body seems to adapt to it pretty well. Is that just from training or just something natural?
Yeah, I think it's quite natural because I don't do like really specific preparation like heat chambers or I don't always do a preparation camp in the heat or something really specific. But from the first year, I struggled on the bike, but the run was quite good the first year. So I always had quite good experiences in Kona. I didn't finish 2015, but all the other races were always consistent and quite strong. So I think the course or the race suits me.
It does suit you.
Yeah.
Well, and also this year has been a great year because you won Challenge Roth, which is one of my favorite races in the world, and you also won Ironman Lanzarote, and 7:59. So you went sub 8 hours and joined that club. I'm round of applause for that, sub 8 at Challenge Roth. How special is that event?
Yeah, I think Challenge Roth is something, it's unbelievable. It's the experience and the crowd, the atmosphere, the finish line, even during the race on the bike course, there's so many people. I think they talk about 260,000 people on that day. It's a great feeling. And Solar Hill as well, it's the place where they all talk about, you know, you feel like a bike rider and in the Tour de France on a climb. Yeah, I think it's something amazing, and not just for the pros, but just for every athlete is enjoying that race so much, and all the local support.
Special.
It's special, yeah.
Yeah, 4,000 individuals, 1,500 people in relays, and what's amazing about that town, the city of Roth, I think, has 14 hotel rooms in that city, right? There's no hotel business that's going to be
generating
homestays.
Homestays. All the athletes stay with local people, and you can just feel that everybody from the town, from the area, is behind that race. And for them, it's the most important day of the year.
It is.
And it's really cool to see that, you know, and to experience that.
The other one, Ironman Lanzarote, that's one of the tougher Ironmans on the planet. Talk a little bit about that race and winning that one.
Yeah, so last year I didn't have a good year at all. So in 2014, I won my first Ironman in Nice. And after that, I was, 2015, 16, especially 16, I was struggling a bit. I didn't have a lot of good races. And then, I just kept doing the same thing. And then I think I'm not the best swimmer. So that's why a more individual race often suits me better. And Ironman Lanzarote is for sure one like that. It's really individual. There are no bike groups or whatever. It's everybody is more on their own, you know. And I love the island. I know the island quite well. I go there a lot for training. And I picked this race for this season. And from that race, I feel really good. And I had a really good preparation for Lanzarote. And it was nice to win an Ironman again.
Yes, it's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while, and to get that feeling back and to know that you do something right, even after a bad season, it's important to just trust in what you do and do the same thing. You know,
is it hard when you have that type of season where you feel like, gosh, I'm training. I feel like I'm training the same, but I'm just not getting the results I was getting before. How do you figure out what's going on? Or is it sometimes just a matter of your body adapting to the training you're doing?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a lot of people ask what's different with this year than last year, for example. I think the training is the same. I just recover a lot better from the training. And somehow I get stronger again with training. And often, like last year, I trained quite good, but then the results were not too good. And I think maybe you lose some confidence in what you do, and you keep doing the same thing, but it's just maybe mentally as well. And, Ironman is a lot about the mental part as well. It's not just a physical part. And I don't know. Somehow, I just kept doing the same thing, and you know, try to focus on what you have to do and stay confident. And yeah, I got it completely back this year. That's for sure.
And recovery, as you know, the more you do this every year, recovery becomes more and more important. Did you change, or maybe take more time off between some workouts?
No, I think it's really important to listen to your body. And if you don't feel like you recover, or the training session doesn't feel right at all, or the training block, I think it's important to adapt. Like sometimes you're not fresh or ready,
sure,
to train hard. And I think it's really important to listen to your body as well. And if you get older, it's sometimes maybe you get you listen too much to the body. You know, that's the cool thing about young guys. They can train so hard and they just keep going. But if you get older, you get maybe a bit too scared of training sometimes. But
yes,
it's still quite important to listen to your body and to listen to your feelings, you know.
Exactly. So when you go sub 8 hours, you go 7:59, were you getting splits? Did you know you were close to going sub 8?
No, I was not getting splits at all. I was not really looking for the sub 8.
The time really wasn't that important, because you were, 23rd after the swim, 4th after the bike, so you were running your way up.
Yeah, but the thing is with Challenge Rote, was only 7 weeks after Lanzarote, and it's actually the first year that I'm doing more than two Ironmans a year. Usually I do one to qualify for Kona.
Right.
And then the race in Kona, and this year I tried something else. I focus more on the only Ironman, not on the half anymore for
right.
this season. And I tried after Lanzarote, I signed up for Rote, and it was a bit of a last minute decision, you know, because I want to race Kona, so I first need to make sure I finish Lanzarote and qualify for Kona. That was the first goal. And then I got the opportunity to still race Rote, and I was not physically not as strong as Lanzarote in Rote, but I think I raced really well tactically.
Yes.
With experience, you know what to do in an Ironman. If you don't feel like 100%, only 95 or 98, you make some other choices in the race, and that's worked really well in Rote. And then the sub 8 hour is really nice, but you know, it's really nice for people, but also sometimes courses change. This year the course was different in Rote,
right?
Even a bit harder to run.
It was harder.
Yeah, it's harder, and so you don't only have to look at the splits. I was just really happy to win the race. That's the most important one.
What would it mean to you to win here?
I think it would mean a lot. You know, I love this race. I think it's the most important. I mean, race in long distance triathlon. It's
right.
The race where a lot of people are. I mean, everybody's dreaming of. And I love the event. That's why I always come back and try to qualify again for next year. But first of all, I'm just looking to improve on my 8th place and my 9th place. And I'm looking for a perfect day in Kona. And I think that's a good start to get closer to the first place.
Have you had close to a perfect day here?
No. I mean, I always had a really consistent race. I have consistent results in Kona. But, you know, I don't have the top result yet. And I think I need a perfect day for that. And, you know, maybe we're just expecting too much from this race to have a perfect day. And it's maybe just really hard to have it here in Kona, because with all the conditions, you know, you're always going to struggle more in this race than in other events.
Yes.
So I think maybe it's really hard to get a perfect day. But on some days, everything works out really well. And then on that day, I think you have to push it really hard. And then maybe you get close to a good position in the end.
So athletes from Belgium have had good luck here, right? Freddie has won here, and Luc van Laert has won here twice. Is the sport getting bigger?
I think in Belgium, the long distance triathlon was always quite big, because you know, we always had good athletes here. We had three wins here in Kona, and that's quite a lot for a small country. I mean, especially in Europe, and I think they know the race already since long. There's a lot of interest for this race still. It's just nice to see that you know, the press, everybody is still loving this event, and
yes,
every year October, beginning of October, they all start to talk about Ironman Hawaii. That's really nice to see, and I think the sport in general is still growing. You know, a lot of people want to give it a try, and they get addicted to it. And I think it's just nice to see that triathlon is still booming. And in Belgium, they even some years we didn't have the best results.
Like right.
Two years ago, we all had a bad race here, but they still covered it and you know, love it, and they come back, or they it's nice to see, you know.
So coming from that duathlon background, how hard was it for you to get to the point in the swim where you could be competitive?
Yeah, it took me quite long, especially here in Kona. I think the swim is, it's such a high level of the field, you know,
and it's so important.
Yeah, and so straight after the start, you know, if you're on your own, you lose so much. I mean, it's crazy. So
yes.
You just need to be in a group at least, and otherwise on your own, it's a really hard swim course. You know, it might look quite easy, the ocean, but because of the level in the field, it's hard if you're not the best swimmer. But I think through the years, I know what to do to swim quite well in an Ironman. I don't have to expect to be in front after the swim. You know, it's also important to know what you can't do, and that you don't have to expect something that's hard to, you know, it's hard to figure. I mean, hard to. Hard to do,
yes.
You know. So
yeah, yeah.
I don't expect to be in the front after the swim, and I just know what to do. I know the race, and I'm looking for a good swim comfortably in a group, not to lose too much energy. And then I know the race starts. Actually, the second part of the bike, that's where the race really starts, and that you can always see the big gaps is often on the way back from Javi, and then the run.
So when you look at it's. The 70.3 distance. In the past, you've done more 70.3s in between the Ironman. Like you said, one Ironman a year. Was it hard for you? Because I think you like to race. Was it hard for you to do less racing and just focus on Ironman races?
Yeah, it's hard. But I think it's also 70.3 is getting really... I mean, it's
so fast.
So fast. But yes. Also, you can't have a weakness at all in Ironman. Also, it's hard. You know, it's generally hard to have a weakness. But in 70.3, a lot of guys struggle to combine. You know, there are not too many guys that combine, especially the world champs. There are not too many guys like Sebastian. He's still trying to do the both, you
right.
know. But for me, especially on the bike, and especially the bike, I have to train different for the half Ironman and for the full distance. And that's why I don't combine them this year. You know, maybe next year it's different again. But this year I just wanted to figure out how to ride really strong for the full 180 kilometers. And we tried something else. And so far
it's working.
It's working, but Kona is different, you know.
Hey, Bart, have a great one on Saturday. Look
Thanks
forward
a lot.
To hopefully seeing you at Four Seasons on Sunday.
I hope so. You know, that would be a really nice surprise.
Love it. Bart Arnautz has been our guest. Round of applause. Pacho Man, take us out.
Oh, here we go. Another day in Kona Town. And breakfast with Bob.
Pacho Man!
Woo! Thank you, Bart.